Josh, you teased us with something yesterday. You were a member of a club.
Yeah, we got. Well, he did a story about a gardening club that was worried that their page was going to get shut down on Facebook because they kept using the word hoe. I don't know why, but my brain immediately latched on to like a gardening club. And I thought that sounds kind of interesting. And then I just thought about, are you a member of a club? And then last hour, we were talking about when was the last time you fainted? And we had a guy call in, and he said he faints on roller coasters because he is a member of a
roller coaster club.
And I was like, this is perfect.
That's
perfect. Exactly what I'm thinking of.
What was a member of a club? What are the what are the requirements to get in? Are there monthly dues to pay? Is there a uniform? What was
yours
club, though, Josh?
Well, it was, I was actually the president of the club.
How many people were in this club?
Well,
is this a send up? Are you messing with us?
No, I'm not messing. This is absolutely true. I think it must have been the second or third grade, elementary school, and I just for some reason, I guess, decided I wanted power. And I
haven't stopped since.
Yeah, and I told some friends that, you want to come over on Sunday. And then one of them said, Josh, you should have a club. And I was like, yeah, I should. And so then the following week, before the Sunday, like on Friday, I started making all these phone calls to people. I called 20 people I knew. And I said, I'm going to be having a club meeting. Starting a club, and the guy who suggested that I start the club, yeah. I called him, and he was like, "Yeah, I was just joking about that. I didn't really think you should start a club."
What was the basis of the club?
Yeah, was what
there
was
any
the theme?
Was
there gardening?
Theme?
Was
there
any books?
Therein lies the problem.
Because that could just be called a group of friends for most people.
There really was no premise. There was no.
It was just the fact that you wanted power over people.
Yeah, theme.
Yeah, there was.
Was a dictatorship.
Yeah, you just wanted to lord over.
Yeah. Okay.
Like seven of my friends showed up, and
they were friends.
I'm
they
here in cult.
They were looking to be part of a club.
There was apple juice and cake at the dining room table. I probably have a picture somewhere.
Okay. And, I'm putting myself in the body of a third grader, showing up at someone's house under the promise of that I'm potentially now joining a club.
Will there be punch and pie?
So I show up and I see cake and apple juice.
I'm glad I joined.
And we haven't joined yet. I'm still in on the fact that I may potentially join a club at this house of a friend from school where that has cake and apple juice. What else was there?
So then, after we ate, they all went outside to play basketball, but I stayed inside. And that was...
You didn't demand that they stay inside, being the leader?
No, because everybody I knew was into sports, but I wasn't into sports. And so they did that, and I don't think I ever... I think maybe the next week I had one or two people at the club, but it disbanded very...
Wow.
Did the club ever have a name?
This is the greatest
I think it was like the Josh Spiegel Club.
There we are.
Oh, my God.
Great branding.
Yeah.
Do we restart the Josh Spiegel Club with cake and punch, no basketball, zero athletics, okay? Call ourselves the bench warmers or something.
Yeah, but it's, like I say, they went out to play basketball without me. It's kind of like a trend with me in my life where people just go out on their own. At my bar mitzvah, at the party on a Sunday, we were out, we were in the room where you eat. And then during the lunch, there were kind of lulls. And all of my friends left to go into another room and watch a football game. Like, they all left.
Okay.
And you just stayed behind.
Yeah, I stayed behind. And then something was happening, and I was told to call them back, so I had to go into the other room to say, could you guys come back now? Because we're gonna wrap up.
We're gonna wrap the bar mitzvah up, guys.
But that's neither here nor there.
Got to peel yourself away from the Dallas game. So I'm hearing that you started a club. There was initially about seven kids.
Yeah.
Everyone's just having dessert. Week two rolls around, big drop off in ratings.
Yeah.
Okay, you got about one or two people there. Did you even attempt a third meeting of the Josh Spiegel Club?
No.
Or at that point, Did they pull it from the lineup?
No, we disbanded. I did once preside over a circus at school.
What? I'm just going to go home.
I'm sorry. Actually, I don't want to
derail.
I have to go.
You presided over a circus? What do you mean? What does that mean?
It's just briefly. In third grade, I like performing.
Natural entertainer.
Yes, I would like to think so. And in the third grade, I persuaded my teacher to allow me to kind of put together a whole show with different people performing and doing different things. And I don't even remember what they were doing. Like one after another, they would do. And it was horrible performances. But I wore this hat, like a circus hat.
Like a P.T. Barnum.
Like a ringleader.
Like a ringmaster.
Yeah.
And what were the performances? What did they consist of? Was there animals? Were there stilt walkers?
No, jumping and
Just a kid jumping.
Human tricks, whatever a kid can do.
Just doing this.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. Over and over again.
And I would introduce it.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I'm sure I have a picture.
Ladies and gentlemen, marvel as young Richie Bennigan eats a pencil from lead to eraser. Watch the human garbage disposal eat an entire pack of staples.
But that was pretty much it. I think I wanted to do a second circus because it really gave me such a high, but they wouldn't let me. The school wouldn't let me.
Sons of bitches.
So it was like a talent show.
It was a circus. It was a circus. I called it a circus.
It was the Josh Spiegel circus.
A circus has like animals and like clowns. This was like a talent show.
I'm hearing circus.